Hi there. I hope you're enjoying this tutorial series on how to build a REST API with Mendix. If you're just tuning in, the last section covered creating a POST method to add vehicles to my collection database. In this video, I'm going to update the POST method to handle adding multiple vehicles to the database in a single call. If you haven't watched the video for creating the base POST method this builds from, I recommend checking it out first. Okay, let's do this. So I've created the method that adds a vehicle to the collection database. What happens if I try to add two vehicles at the same time? If I open the POST method and paste in a JSON message with multiple vehicles and click execute, everything seems to work fine, but does it? Let's run the getVehicles method to see if these new vehicles have been added to the database. I guess not. Now, why that's happening is a result of how the microflow for adding vehicles to the database is currently built. It's looking for a single vehicle object in the JSON message to add or update. To enable the REST method to accept multiple vehicles in one message, we need to update the microflow. Let's do that now. Inside the desktop modeler, let's go back to the Add Vehicles microflow. If you recall from the last video, it's relatively simple. We've got our vehicle object, and the flow itself contains no actions because the API takes care of committing the data from the import message we defined. But now we want to expand the capability to add multiple. Thankfully, it's super simple. Open up the properties for the vehicle object. Change the data type to a list, and add list to the end of the name to give it context. Now that's all that has to be done, but I want to output the list when the data is added to the database correctly. To do that, I'm going to export the vehicle list to a string in JSON format. Then I'll drop a change object on the microflow and choose the HTTP response object. I'm going to set the status code to 201 to indicate creation, set the HTTP version to http://1.1, and add the vehicle JSON string from the export activity as the content. The last thing I need to do is add a new object and create a new HTTP header. The HTTP header will carry the response back to the browser. Open the new object properties and set it to a system.http header. Now add a key value pair where the key is content and the value is application/json. For the system.http message, add the HTTP response object. All right, let's spin up the app again. I'll refresh the web page and click on Post. Then I'll add the JSON object with multiple cars into the dialog box. Click execute and watch the magic happen. The browser shows the response as a 201, and the JSON we input is sent back as the output. Cool, everything worked. If we run the get method again, you can see we have three cars. In the next video, I'll build a delete method as we say goodbye to one of the cars in my collection. Stay tuned.